to get to his next level, but the man, he was trying to get to it, and all of a sudden, they said the man was looking for a good friend, and he got in the car, started driving down the street. I'm starting to feel my help here. He got down the street, and all of a sudden, he said that there was a person on side of him that was robbing. And all of a sudden, he got to the house, and his grandmother was on the porch. He said, have you found Jesus yet? He's a real good boy. I'm trying to tell you something. He said, have you found him yet? The boy said, no. I've never heard of him. Another day in my life. He said, I don't understand. When will I meet him? The old woman said, when you meet Jesus, I'm sure you'll know him. He said, he's a friend, more than you'll ever meet. The boy man, the young man, went out on the day and started to drive. But when he started driving, the car started to skid on the road. It started spinning around. And then when it got to the house, he stopped on the dime. Stuck with no bruises. The car flipped over and landed on the field. Landed on four tires. And he jumped out the car, screaming at the woman, Where is the man? Yeah. He said, where is the man? Everybody looked at him crazy and said, who in the world are you talking about? Ain't nobody in the car with you. He said, when my car was spinning round and round, I seen the man that was dressed in white. He had hair like sheep, like lamb's wool, and his eyes were like fire blacks. And while the car was spinning, he took control of the wheel, and even though it flipped, it shocked on the tires. Well, what do you know? He said, where is that man? All of a sudden, the old woman came out. She said, what seems to be the trouble? The man said, he said, where is that? Where is that man? Who are you talking about, baby? He said, I told you, he had no hands, and he had a hand like a lamb's wool. He had eyes like fire brands. But wait a minute, the old woman said, I think I know who you're talking about. I think that's my best friend. I told you about him, but I need you to be specific. Do you have holes? Yeah, in his hands. Do you have holes? In his feet. Did his face look a little messed up? Like he's been beaten in the fire. And he said, yeah. The old lady looked at him and said, good news to the child. You just met Jesus. He's a real friend. And that's what I want to leave you with. Is there anybody here that can testify on the day that say, neighbor, I was in a car wreck of a dangerous situation. The Lord was watching me as my life turned around and spin upside down. But thank God, the Lord took control of the wheel. What do you say, Jarrod? Let the enemy meant for evil. The Lord meant it for good. Is there anybody here grabbing nobody, grab you two things that I may not know. But the one thing that I'm sure of, yes, 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 he's a real friend. And what can I tell you about my friend? He makes me happy when I'm sad. He lifts me up, turns me around, place my feet on the solid ground. You know that man, some call him counselor, some call him Prince of Peace. But if you know him, like you know him, if he's your friend, you know him by his name. His name is Jesus. But wait a minute, y'all. The reason why I praise is because my friend did something for me. When they put a cross upon his shoulder, they marched up God's hill. My friend, your friend, they hung him high and stretched him out. You can know what happened. He died. He died. He died. Sunday morning, he got on the power in his hands. So my question to you this morning is, to anybody here today that can testify, I am a living testimony, and I thank the Lord that I'm still alive. Why you alive? Because he walks with me, he talks with me, he tells me that I am his own, and it's not, yes, it's not, that we share, that we carry there. No other has ever known. Well, how do you know, Jarrod? Because I went to my friend, I came to Jesus, yeah, I came to Jesus, just as a word. If you win your heart, you ought to be able to testify. I was really long and sad, yes, sir. But I found in him a sweet old resting place. And thanks be to God, he's raving. Yeah, he's making glad. Turn to testify. I don't mean to be rude, but grab one more name. Grab one more name. Grab one by the hand. Rockin' and shakin', shakin' and rockin', shakin' like a polar preacher. And tell a neighbor, don't be discouraged, don't be distressed, don't give up, don't go in the towel, cause weeping may, yes, weeping may, and good for a night, but shout, yes, shout, yeah, Jesus. Ah! Saw it comes in the morning. Not in this running, I left me. Tell somebody that I am what I am. Because the Lord, he loves me so much that he left him in his hands. He loves me so much that he left him in his feet. He loves me so much that he died for me. It does not matter what people say. All that matters is that the Lord still got his hands on my life. Don't be discouraged. Don't be distressed. Be not dismayed. But every time you have, God will. God will. God will. God will. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Open up your mouth and shout hallelujah.